Now sit back, relax, and I hope you enjoy. Much love to all.
Chakra is a concept referring to wheel-like vortices which, according to traditional Indian medicine, are believed to exist in the surface of the etheric double of man. The chakras are said to be force centers, or whorls of energy permeating, from a point on the physical body, the layers of the subtle bodies in an ever-increasing fan-shaped formation. Rotating vortices of subtle matter, they are considered the focal points for the reception and transmission of energies. Different systems posit a varying number of chakras. The most well-known system in the West is that of seven chakras. It is typical for chakras to be depicted as either flower-like or wheel-like. In the former, petals are shown around the perimeter of a circle. In the latter, spokes divide the circle into segments that make the chakra resemble a wheel, or chakra. Each chakra possesses a specific number of segments or petals. The word comes from the Sanskrit chakra, meaning wheel, circle, and sometimes also referring to the wheel of life. The pronunciation of this word can be approximated in English by chakra, with ch as in chart. In both instances, the commonly found pronunciation, chakra, is incorrect. The seven main chakras are described as being aligned in an ascending column from the base of the spine to the top of the head. Each chakra is associated with a certain color, multiple specific functions, an aspect of consciousness, a classical element, and other distinguishing characteristics. The chakras are thought to vitalize the physical body and to be associated with interactions of both a physical and mental nature. They are considered loci of life energy, or prana, which is thought to flow among them along pathways called nadis. In mysticism, a nadi, plural, nadis, is an energy channel in which prana energy flows and may connect chakras. It is not accepted by mainstream science. The main nadis include Sushumna, Ida, and Pingala. Nadis are thought to carry a life force energy known as prana in Sanskrit, or qi in Chinese-based systems. They are also said to have an extrasensory function, playing a part in empathic and instinctive responses. Nadis are sometimes viewed as extending only to the skin of the body, but are often thought to extend to the boundary of the aura. The Ida and Pingala nadis are often seen as referring to the two hemispheres of the brain. Pingala is the extroverted, solar nadi, and corresponds to the left-hand side of the brain. Ida is the introverted, lunar nadi, and refers to the right-hand side of the brain. The two nadis are stimulated through the practice of pranayama, which involves alternate breathing through left and right nostrils, which would alternately stimulate the left and right sides of the brain. The word nadi comes from the Sanskrit root nad, meaning channel, stream, or flow. The earliest known mention of chakras is found in the later Upanishads, including specifically the Brahma Upanishad and the Yogatattva Upanishad. These Vedic models were adapted in Tibetan Buddhism as Vajrayana theory, and in the Tantric Shakta theory of chakras. It is the Shakta theory of seven main chakras that most people in the West adhere to, either knowingly or unknowingly, largely thanks to a translation of two Indian texts, the Sat Chakra Nirupana and the Padaka Pankeka, by Sir John Woodruff, alias Arthur Avalon, in a book entitled The Serpent Power. The highest crown chakra is said to be the chakra of consciousness, the master chakra that controls all the others. Its role would be very similar to that of the pituitary gland, which secretes hormones to control the rest of the endocrine system, and also connects to the central nervous system via the hypothalamus. The thalamus is thought to have a key role in the physical basis of consciousness. The ajna chakra, or third eye, is linked to the pineal gland. Ajna is the chakra of time and awareness and of light. The pineal gland is a light-sensitive gland that produces the hormone melatonin, which regulates the instinct of going to sleep and awakening. It also produces trace amounts of the psychedelic chemical dimethyltryptamine. Note: some argue that the pineal and pituitary glands should be exchanged in their relationship to the crown and brow chakras, based on the description in Arthur Avalon's book on Kundalini called Serpent Power. The throat chakra, Vishuddha, is said to be related to communication and growth, growth being a form of expression. This chakra is paralleled to the thyroid, a gland that is also in the throat, and which produces thyroid hormone, responsible for growth and maturation.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.